Welcome to All About the Bay, where we showcase the products and services of all small businesses in our area. With me on the show today is Ms. Gloria Santos Cardon. She's a longtime Bay Area resident and she provides some wonderful financial services. Welcome to the show, Gloria.
Thank you, Paul, for having me here.
Now, tell me, who are you and what do you do?
Paul, I'm with the financial industry for the past 12 years. And what we do is we teach people how money works. And then at the same time, how they can preserve their wealth up to the last generation.
So how money works and how to preserve your money?
Yeah, wealth and asset. Now, we have a very good programs, but I'm just going to talk about the very popular ones.
Okay, great. Awesome.
Okay, one of them is our pension plan. That's it's sort of similar with 401k, but the difference is, let's say you want to contribute for your retirement income, you only have to put 5 years, while the banks will contribute for 10 years, and you don't have to pay the bank. And it, inside it, it has a built-in life insurance, protect your wealth, your family, and your income, and your health.
So what's this program called?
It's called Kaizen program.
Kaizen.
Kaizen program.
Okay.
That's one of them. And the second one is when you have a 401k or IRA, that's taxable, you can roll it over to non-taxable. Mm-hmm. That's number two. And number three, we have this capital gains tax deferment for 30 years instead of you paying Uncle Sam that, let's say, $500,000 or $1 million, you defer that, you can use that money, Uncle Sam's money, and invest it in some other ways, and the beneficiary will take care of that. Mm-hmm. And number four, we have a program also that helps businesses, even common people, that if you want to be a partner to their business, you get profit sharing. If you don't cannot come up with cash, and you have a very good credit, and the company will help you create that money using bank's money or other people's money.
Okay, so that's a broad overview of what you provide. Mm-hmm. Now let's go into some details. Number one, the Kaizen program. Well, tell us more about it.
Kaizen program, as I told you about, is a very good retirement plan, where a person can contribute 5 years only, and that's it. But the bank will contribute for 10 years. I have a client, okay? I'm not gonna mention the name. He is 35 years old, and now he's contributing $2,000 a month for his 401k. Mm-hmm. And I said, how long are you gonna contribute? He said, as long as I'm with the company. Does the company contribute half of that? No, not really, just a part of it. So I said, what if I tell you that you only have to contribute 5 years and the bank will contribute 10 years? Mm-hmm. You don't have to pay the bank. Mm-hmm. Like in your case, 5 years, let's summarize that, $120,000 for 5 years. Mm-hmm. Well, the bank will contribute almost $300,000. Mm-hmm. And you don't pay them back. Mm-hmm. Because it's not a loan. And inside of that, there's a built-in life insurance, mm-hmm, that covers you in $1 million. And my client said, what if anything happens to me in the second year? Don't worry about it. Your family is protected. Mm. When I did your illustration, you start with 1.3 million coverage. The second year, anything happens to you, your family will get 1.2 million. Mm-hmm. And by the time, the requirements is the terms and conditions, you have to be healthy and you're earning $100,000 or more. Mm-hmm. With a couple makes $50,000, the other one makes $60,000, that's $100,000, you can be qualified for
it. Okay, let's talk about, okay, you say the qualification, basically you have to make $100,000. So most of our audience basically are small business owners, right?
Mm-hmm.
How do you verify that income?
Well, we have to check their W-2 or 1099.
That's small business owners. Okay, so a small business owner might not have W-2s, might not have 1099s.
Yeah, that's why I said as long as they can provide a proof that they're earning this much, the tax, mm-hmm. Income tax.
Oh, okay. So small businesses, as you know, basically they make $200,000, but they only pay $25,000. They only show in the income taxes they make $25,000. How do you overcome that problem?
We base it on the net income.
Okay, you base it on net income. So that might be tough for a lot of small businesses, right?
Yeah.
But you're saying that so long as somebody can show that they make $100,000 net, mm-hmm. okay, they qualify for your program. What's a minimum contribution?
It depends on the age. Because the younger the person is, the smaller his contribution. Mm-hmm. The older he gets, he has to put more money. And the banks will put more money too.
Okay, let me understand. I'm trying to understand this. Okay, if you're working for some company, right? Mm-hmm. Then the company benefits because you're working for them.
Yeah.
For the 401k.
Yeah.
So in this case, you're saying that, okay, which bank is this, right? Let's say I contribute $2,000 a month, right? Okay, which bank is this that would give the... will match what I contribute? Do they match it or do they exceed it? What was it?
Usually they exceeded it.
Okay, so what's the ratio? Do you know?
Well, I say about doubles.
Okay, all right, so I put $2,000
a month. Like my client.
Yes.
He's $120,000 in 5 years.
Yes.
The bank will give him $298,000.
That's even more than double.
Yeah.
Yes.
It's even more.
Okay, so what does the bank benefit from this?
Well, the bank benefits because the bank invests his money and the bank's money.
Okay. I see. All right. So
they mix it together.
Okay, I see. They mingle. Okay, mm-hmm. I see. So of course that's something anybody wants to know details about they can talk to you. Uh-huh. Because I have questions about that.
Yes.
Okay, cool. That's number one. Right, so you're helping small business people, right, to create their own 401k.
Yeah.
Is it only for small business people or is it for anybody?
For anybody.
Okay, I see. Interesting. So you can be W-2, you can be anybody.
Oh yeah, as long as you have income.
Instead of contributing to your 401k, mm-hmm. right?
Yeah.
You can just opt out, don't contribute to mm-hmm. 401k, mm-hmm. and you contribute towards this fund, Kaizen fund, right?
Yes. Yes.
And you contribute only for 5 years. And
the
bank will contribute for 10 years.
Yes.
Right? And mm-hmm. all that kind of stuff. You're done. And it has 401k doesn't have the insurance element.
No.
But your thing has the insurance
yes.
element. That's a great
yes.
deal. Number two, what's your number two plan here?
Well, number two plan is we have this program that we want to be an investor, profit sharing of the company. Mm-hmm. Then if you have the list now is $100,000. Dollars, okay? Mm-hmm. Now, mm-hmm. if you don't have that $100,000 to join their company, you can use your credit. If you have a good credit, then we can come up with, create money for them. Now, once they created that money, okay, 15% will be retained by the person who has that credit because the money will go to his bank account. And 85% will be invested to the company. A corporation, that company buys businesses, different kind of businesses. They can buy real estate, trucking, any kind of businesses. Now they're looking at the Walmart, e-commerce. Now once they will have to get another corporate funding from the bank. Once that corporate funding was ready, they will give a sign-up bonus to that person who has that $100,000 created. They give back that sign up bonus. It's called sign up bonus $100,000. Mm-hmm. So mm-hmm. that person didn't put up any money at all. So he was, and then at the same time, he's already considered a business owner, an investor. So once he has interest in, then he will get profit sharing 50-50%. 50-50 profit sharing. And he didn't, let's say I have a good.
I'm trying to understand this. Is this for a startup business or is it for any business?
Any business.
Okay, so I'm trying to find out how an investor who comes in $100,000 will share 100% or 50-50 of that company. Let's say for my company, mm-hmm. right?
Yeah.
Okay, I've been working on this company okay. for a long time, for 10 years and stuff like that. Uh-huh. And the company is now, maybe the value is $1.5 million, for example. Okay, and so and then I'm looking to raise capital.
Uh-huh.
And then I come to you, I bring an investor, somebody has good credit. We use that person good credit, they get $100,000,
uh-huh.
okay, and a portion of that, not all of it comes from my company, mm-hmm. but a portion of that comes from my company, and now I'm giving 50% ownership of the...
Yes, yes.
I mean, how is that beneficial to me as a business owner?
Mm-hmm.
No, how?
How?
Yes.
Then you get 50% of the company
no,
sharing.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Why is it?
Because you help them use mm-hmm. your credit to raise money.
Mm-hmm.
Because once that money... is let's say 100,000 was created on your behalf. Let's say you use your credit on your behalf, okay? Once that money, at the same time, the company is trying to borrow corporate funding also.
Mm-hmm.
And it will show that they have this 100,000 and they have, and then they will get.
Well, I think, okay, this is something offline that we could talk about or whoever's interested
yeah.
can talk to you because mm-hmm. what I was thinking like, hey, the company's already worth this much. If it's a startup, I can understand.
Mm-hmm.
But if the company's already worth $1.2 million and somebody raises $100,000 for that company that's worth $1.2 million, you know, it does not benefit the business owner. Maybe it benefits the guy who's coming in with their credit, not the business owner. Because the business owner working for the last 10 years, the company now worth $1.5 million, that person brings in $100,000, and then that person now going to share a profit with this business owner 50-50, you know, it doesn't benefit the business owner that much. It benefits that other person. You know what I'm saying? But that's something that we could talk offline. Number mm-hmm. three, what's your number three thing?
Number three thing is a capital gains tax deferment.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
That, you know, when you sell your property worth, let's say you bought it for $100,000.
Right.
And the property now is worth $2
million. Mm-hmm.
This capital gains tax is so huge, right?
Right.
Now we have a program that you don't have to pay Uncle Sam. Let's mm-hmm. say capital gains tax is $1 million.
Mm-hmm.
We have a program that's deferred that capital gains tax for 30 years.
Mm-hmm.
And then our lawyers doing that, helping. This is nationwide, not only in California.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you can use that Uncle Sam's money. Say, Uncle Sam, I'm going to use your money.
Well, it's not even you. Uncle Sam's money. It's your money.
Well, because that's for Uncle Sam's, the capital gains tax.
Right,
let's say
right.
$1 million capital gains tax. You don't have to give it to Uncle Sam yet.
Yes.
You use
yes.
that money, mm-hmm. I don't know, you invest, buy property,
right.
buy businesses, mm-hmm. and then there will be a trust that will be created by your for the beneficiary. Mm-hmm. That something happens to you, then that money will be available to Uncle Sam.
Mm-hmm.
We use life insurance to cover that. So you don't actually, you only put a little,
mm-hmm.
and you use life insurance money. So mm-hmm. that's the loophole that we do.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Well, I can understand that once somebody sells their property, typically they're going to have what they call 1031 exchange,
mm-hmm.
right? And
yeah.
so they need to find another property within 45
yeah.
days after they sell their property.
Yes.
And then within 180 days, they must exercise option and buy that property. So you're saying there is an alternative to that because
oh,
you
yeah.
are in helping people create and preserve wealth.
Mm-hmm.
So why pay 40% to Uncle Sam, whereas you can actually defer that for the next 30 years, and then you use the insurance
money.
Policy
yeah.
to defer that, I mean, to cover that.
Yes.
So that's a good thing. I think that if somebody's listening to this, that'll be very beneficial to them,
mm-hmm.
right?
Yep.
Number four, what's the number four thing?
Number four is our mortgage accelerator.
Okay.
Then we can shorten the years of payment,
mm-hmm.
and we have this software, we call it like GPS. We show them how to accelerate their payment. You know, instead of paying 30 years, we can show it to you. Maybe you can just pay for 10 years. It depends on how much money you have, you
mm-hmm.
know. So this GPS is telling you when to pay, how much to pay.
Mm-hmm.
It's very simple.
That's interesting. So, okay,
mm-hmm.
so you talked about creating your own retirement fund.
Yes.
Number two is actually telling you, okay, you can use your credit,
mm-hmm.
right, good credit to
yes.
create wealth. Number three is talking about, you know, 1031 deferment, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And number four is I can talk about how to pay off your mortgage very quick.
Yes.
And you have some other programs, but this is what the core things, the core four programs we want to talk about today.
Yes.
That's interesting.
Mm-hmm.
That's wonderful. So, and you've been doing this for a long time, right?
These other programs about 5 years ago.
Yeah, but you've been doing
yes, yes.
You know, financial
yeah.
stuff
mm-hmm.
since.
In fact, I've been helping 3 clients now for the Kaizen program, mm-hmm. also for get money from the banks, mm-hmm. you know, the credit, mm-hmm. using the credit. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And also, I forgot to tell you, mention to you that this company, once you become an investor, mm-hmm. partner of them, mm-hmm. You have they will issue stocks for you, mm-hmm. stocks, and they're going to go IPO. So it's not only you're putting money for one business, they buy businesses, so you can own some more businesses as you go along. Let's mm-hmm. say you make money here, mm-hmm. and you're getting paid
using
every month.
Using your credit.
And if you don't have
a shareholder of businesses.
Yeah.
No penny come out of your pocket.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay.
I have this friend, he already has these people lined up getting.
What's the minimum credit score?
I said about 750.
Mm-hmm. 750. So mm-hmm. so long as you have a 750 credit score, you can be a multi-business owner.
Yeah, yeah, that's true. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And I'm interested onto that too. Mm-hmm. You mm-hmm. know, but I'll be sitting here making money.
Yes.
And well, because I'm a partner to them, they're mm-hmm. gonna go IPO also. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So it's pretty awesome.
Okay, so thank you so much for joining us on the show. If somebody wants to contact you, how do they contact you?
They can call me 510-300-5438, and then I have an email address also. So I will put that on my resume also. And just give me a call, and my services is free.
Okay. You can contact me at 510-300-5438, email address riacardon.feg@gmail.com. My website is gloriacardon.freedomequitygroup.com.
Thanks for watching. If you know of any small business owners who would like to take advantage of our lively interviews, please ask them to contact us at service@allaboutthebay.org. And remember to subscribe to our channel as we post new interviews there weekly.